Imagine that you have lots and lots of data that you need to analyze in Microsoft Excel. Yeah, lots and lots of data. Of course, I could insert a pivot table or use formulas and functions to try to make sense of it all. That is, if you even know how to use them. Or you can simply hire your very own AI data analyst to do all of that work for you. Let's check this out. To get your very own personal AI data analyst, head to the following website. And you may recognize this. This is ChatGPT. And down below, you have the familiar chat box where you can interact and talk with the AI. Over on the left-hand side, there's now some new functionality called Explore GPTs. These are custom GPTs, and in a moment, we'll see what you can do. To be able to see this, you need a premium subscription to ChatGPT. If you don't have that, this functionality may compel you to go premium. Let's click on this option. This now drops us into GPTs, and here you'll find all of the different custom GPTs. In fact, in the top right-hand corner, you can even create your very own GPT. That's a fun one to test out. On the page here, you can search for various public GPTs. You also have categories of different GPTs. And if you scroll down just a little bit, you'll see some of the featured and also trending GPTs. These are different GPTs that organizations and also individuals have pulled together and have made available. So as a few examples here, if I scroll down at trending, here we see Canva. You could design logos or presentations using ChatGPT. Down below, another fun example. Here, you could turn yourself into a cartoon, simply load an image of yourself, and all of a sudden, you'll see what you look like in a Pixar-like image. If we scroll down just a little bit, there's a category called By ChatGPT. These are different custom GPTs made by OpenAI, or the maker of ChatGPT. Here, we could see more, and you have all sorts of different options. Right at the very top, one of the most popular ones is called the Data Analyst, and this will analyze data on your behalf. And it is truly mind-boggling what it can do. Let's click into this one. This now drops us into the Data Analyst. And at first glance, it looks somewhat unassuming. We just have this basic white background, and you have a very simple text box down below. But just wait until you see what it's capable of. To analyze some data, first we need to load some data. Down in the text box, you can click on this paperclip icon, or alternatively, you can also drag and drop a data file into the Data Analyst. Here, I'm going to drop in an Excel file, and if you'd like to follow along, I've included this same exact Excel file in the description of this video. Before we start asking questions about our data, let's take a quick look to see what's contained within this Excel file. The Excel spreadsheet contains order data for customers here at the Kevin Cookie Company. We have order IDs, there are also customer IDs, how many cookies we shipped, revenue, also the cost. There's no profit here, but you could calculate that. And then also the order date. And that's all on this first worksheet titled Orders. There's also a second worksheet titled Customers, and this contains all of the customer data here at the Kevin Cookie Company. Right up here, you'll see that this sheet ties to the order sheet based on the customer ID. And over here, you'll see that we have 5 customers, and you'll see all the different customer information. Back now within the Data Analyst, let's start with a really easy question. Down below, I'm going to ask, how many customers does the Kevin Cookie Company have? If you remember when we looked at this spreadsheet, we have 5 unique customers. Let's send the message to see what it comes back with. And look at that, it successfully identifies that we have 5 customers here at the Kevin Cookie Company. Now, of course, that was a simple question, but what I really appreciate is it also walks me through how it went about getting that information. So over here, it starts by analyzing the overall structure of the Excel workbook. Over here, it found that there were 2 different worksheets. One titled Orders and one titled Customers. And then because I'm asking about customers, it believes that that information is in the customer sheet. And here it walks me through step by step how it went about doing that. By showing me how it does it, it gives me more confidence that it was able to find the correct information. Let's now try a question that's a little bit more complicated. Down below, I'll type in which customer ordered the most cookies. Now, you might be thinking, well, that's not that hard of a question, but the reason it's a little bit more complex is that it uses some information from the customer sheet and it uses some information from the orders sheet. So it has to tie these two sheets together. Let's see what it comes back with. And look at that. Here it tells me that it's Cascade Grovers with a total of 667,698 cookies. And I went back to Excel just to double check that, and that is spot on. Back here in Excel, just so you appreciate what it just did, here it took all the different customer IDs and it aggregated or figured out the sum of cookies shipped by the customer ID. Once it had that information, it figured out which one ordered the most. Then it went over to the customer sheet, and for the customer who ordered the most, then it connected it to this customer name. That is so impressive, and it's amazing how easy the data analyst makes all of this work. In Excel, you would have to set up a pivot table. You'd have to feed in both of these different tables. Of course, that's doable, but it takes some knowledge of Excel, and it also takes some effort. You're probably getting the idea now that the data analyst is fairly capable, but can it make visuals? Well, let's test it out. Down below, let's see if maybe it can make a bar chart showing profit by year. Now remember, the workbook doesn't actually contain the profit. We just had the revenue and the cost. So first it'll have to calculate the profit. Over here, let's see what it comes back with. And look at that. Like I've always said, there is money in the cookie business. If we scroll up just a little bit, we can see what it did. Here, first it calculated the profit. It took the revenue and it subtracted the cost. That's how you get the profit. And then here it walks through all the other steps. And this is beautiful, but if we look over at the y-axis, here it provided the profit in this weird notation. I want to see it in just currency format. So I want to make some modifications to this bar chart. Down below in the text box, let's see if we can make changes. I'll say, can you show the y-axis in USD currency format in millions? Let's try that. And look at that. Over on the y-axis, we now see different notation. That's a lot easier to comprehend. Let's also try one more quick change here. Can you change the bars to green? We had all this profit and nothing speaks money and profit like green. So let's try that. And look at that. Now I have green bars. That is so much easier than fumbling through menus in Excel trying to format the color of a chart. This makes things so much easier. Now, let's see if I can outsource all of my work. Down below, let's see if it can also think. Why was profit flat from 2021 to 2022? I would have expected some growth. I mean, we've been killing it in the cookie industry. Let's see what it comes back with. And just like that, here it pulls together a detailed analysis for why the profit might have been flat between those years. For example, here it said maybe the sales were stagnant, or maybe we had a change in the product mix or pricing. And here it goes through and it analyzes all the available data. This will give me lots of good information to think about. Now, I want to try one last question. Let's see if there are any seasonal trends in cookie sales. My boss keeps asking me about that, so let's see if maybe the data analyst can help me. Over here, let's send this message. Right up above, the data analyst has now aggregated all of the cookies shipped by month of the year. And here at the end of the year, I see this massive spike in December. If we scroll down just a little bit more, here it hypothesizes that this could correlate with holiday seasons. Well, that's the Christmas holiday, and we do see a lot more cookie sales that time of the year. I'll have to tell my boss what I learned. As you can see, you don't have to know how to use a tool like Excel, Power BI, or Tableau to get insights from your data. You just have to be willing to prompt the AI, and then you can unlock all of those insights. The value no longer comes from knowing how to use the tools, but instead to ask the right questions and then to make the right decisions. Imagine what this can do for your business or your research or any other task. It's truly incredible. To watch more videos like this one, please consider subscribing, and I'll see you in the next video.